Jack Twatchman. I am the vice president of Borough Bags, part owner of Borough Bar. I write for EU Jacksonville, and I'm a student, among other things. What got me, I guess, more specifically here was I read about Borough Bags while I was in Afghanistan. I had an idea for a custom bag made out of like my sea bag and my uniform and stuff. So I came, went to the shop, met Matt, told him my idea. I'm like, okay, cool. Bag turned out awesome. And I just started hanging around. I was also really getting back into bicycles at the time. So Zombie Bikes was there. They shared space, just started hanging out. Eventually, Borough launched a new website, and I was like, you guys need someone to manage this website. Y'all are making bags, making sales, you know, like, you need to be telling the world what's going on, like, on a regular basis. So like, all right. So it's kind of like, you know, a handshake, and I had the job of just like, web dude. And from there, the opportunity presented itself to, you know, become more invested, involved, and I took it because it's something I feel, you know, very passionate about. I really like the product. It doesn't make me a whole lot of money, but that's not what it's about. And then this place kind of fell in our lap. Couldn't resist. What people, a lot of people fail to do is find the right people to help them achieve their goals and dreams and stuff. Because it's like you have an idea and you want to own it, and that's like the tendency. It's like, you know, I don't know, you treasure that little idea and you want to make it your own, so you try and do it all yourself, and that very rarely works. So try to do several things just all by myself because I'm a micromanager and I'm a little bit OCD, and none of those things ever worked. It was only when I was like, all right, I guess I need some help. You know, you can just do whatever you think is best for this situation, and just kind of like being open is what has really actually made the things that have become successful. Jacksonville is just like a clean slate as far as, I mean, literally anything you want to do, very little of that has been done, like, they can't be improved, basically. Yeah, I just call Tony out already, usually. It's usually the answer most problems I've town. It's just kind of like a, you know, a guy you go to when you need something to happen. He knows all the right people to talk to. If he can't solve your problem, he knows someone can, basically. But he's also a patron. He helped us get our first location. He basically took a property that was not going to sell, still not going to sell, and just said, hey, here's some kids that are doing stuff. Let's just get them in there. Talked to the property owner. Got him to let us occupy the space, do what we were doing. That, you know, found that starting point for us to grow. Content, that's what I'm working on right now. This place is way more challenging because people aren't just here at night during the week, you know. They have their neighborhood bars for that. So getting them out here to spend their money and keeping it like in line with my, you know, tastes and preferences, which are somewhat narrow, is a real challenge. So I was thinking of, you know, creative ways to use this space and the resources that we have. Now I'm, you know, working with other people, but for each night, like, I'm teaming up. Like, I have Thursday nights here is when I work, but, and I was gonna, like, brand it myself, and, you know, but then I was like, you know what? Let's go with something that's, you know, more people are going to be into because of my taste, like I said, over here. So we're teaming up with Devin Valera, who DJs the Indie Endeavor program on JCT on Tuesday nights. So she's going to come in. We're going to do some form of a live version of her radio show here. So you might like be interviewing people, just playing new music that people haven't heard yet and stuff. So Jacksonville burned down in whatever the hell, I don't know, 1901 or whatever. And it was rebuilt. And now we kind of need to burn it down.